Welcome to Christ Clarity, where we keep it simple, and you'll find yourself in very familiar territory, video after video. Many of you have come over here with a background in A Course in Miracles, ACIM, and you find here it's much simpler, much more basic, right? But I tell you, this was really the purpose of the Course in the first place, is to get to this simplicity. There was a time when the Course came on the scene and the world was severely stuck in a rut of academia, of linear thinking and processing. And the Course in Miracles got us out of that rut. That was its primary purpose, because we were severely stuck. We're no longer stuck that bad. And so the Course had this ABC 1, 2, 3, the lessons, and there seemed to be some linear progress to it because people were so enmeshed in the idea and the necessity of pleasing the professor, getting the degree, doing well on the tests. So we need to study. How can we prove we're making progress? Well, here's lesson 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I've made progress. Here's chapter 1, 2, 3, 4. Let me number the pages, number the paragraphs, number the sentences. So, okay, I did this. I did page such and such of the text, such and such a chapter, page, paragraph, sentence. I'm reading that now. And so that's very linear. And we felt we needed to please the authorities of the time, the academic authorities, the professors. Okay, but we don't have to do that anymore. I'm not a professor. Nobody needs to feel they need to be a co-ed and try to please the professor. You know, I'm being so nice and cute and friendly and attractive, and I'm buttering up the professor. You know, I have to do these things. You know, nobody has to do that anymore. There's no professor here. There's no need to impress any professor. Just be yourself. You can relax. You don't need to put on any airs. You can let go of all of that. You don't need to be a go-getter. You're not trying to find a grade here. There's no grades being given out. There's no thesis expected of you. You don't have to write a Ph.D. thesis. You know, before, if you didn't publish if you didn't get a Ph.D. and you didn't then publish after that, you were nothing. As far as status goes, you were nothing. No one would listen to you. You had no authority. And now that's changed. Partly because of your decision. You realize, you're waking up, say, whoa, wait a minute. Maybe the ones who are really wise never even participated in that game in the first place. No need to. It's much simpler than that. I can make a much more direct approach. I don't need to go through academic authorities. Any video you open up here is familiar territory. We'll have the simple facts there, and it will be very helpful to you, lessen your fixation on the silly idea that spirit that we chose. Any video, there's not a progression like that. There's not a progression of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you know, that kind of thing. We don't need that. We're past that now. The Course got us past that, got many past it. Some didn't even need that. They're already past it. Some were just inherently very intuitive, very big picture oriented, realize no need to impress any sort of a mental authority, emotional authority, anything like that. Just need to clarify, just need to lessen the fixation. That's it. There are no tests being given out. And again, you don't have to go out and write a book. You don't have to take notes. What do you take notes for? It's very simple. But we are a spirit. We chose a silly idea. We've been fixated on that silly idea. Now we're lessening the fixation on that silly idea. That's it. You don't need any notes for that. You say, well, I'm going to forget. Well, tomorrow, come back and choose another video. You'll be reminded again. And gradually, you won't forget so much. And you may think, well, there's a test coming up. I'm sure there's a test coming up. We've all been indoctrinated into this educational system, which promises you status. And so many are frantically pursuing that status. It's all important. And they constantly feel they've got to do good on a test. They've got to ace the test. So where's the information, you know? I need to find more sophistication, more details. I got to impress the professor. I've got to write a paper. So I need notes, notes, notes. There's no notes needed. Does God need for you to take notes? Is God giving you a test? No, it's a simple reminding. It's just a reminder. And a noticing of the ways we've kept ourselves fixated. Just a noticing, to notice it. It's subtle. You'll see it. You'll have a moment, you're driving in your car, and suddenly you will see, oh my gosh, what a silly thing I've been doing. I've been tricking myself this way. And you'll just, in a flash, you'll see it. And then when you think about, how can I explain this to someone? You realize you can't. And then you'll start getting fuzzy. As you try to put it into words, it gets fuzzy. Because you want to impress the Ph.D., you want to impress them, the psychologists and the psychiatrists and everybody with degrees who seem to be authorities over your life, who have the power and capacity to bestow status upon you. If you play that game, you want to impress them and you need to come up with some words, but you don't need to impress God. You don't need to impress Christ. Because they know it's simpler than that. It's as simple as choosing a new idea. It's as simple as functioning as you truly are. You really have not been diminished in the slightest bit, but your fixation on this one silly idea to the exclusion of all other ideas has resulted in a feeling as if you're somehow incompetent. Because you're not functioning the way you were created to function. You were functioned to flow through a tapestry of ideas. Instead, you're fixated on just one idea and trying to flow through the tapestry of effects of that idea, but that's not the same. It's not the same. So you feel incompetent, and then you look for someone who will bestow symbol of competence upon you, and then you say, academia, if I get that PhD, that doctor, whatever, then that I can walk around and I can feel competent. People will look at me and say, there goes someone who's very competent. That's what your hope is. And yet you found out that feeling of incompetence is still there. Hasn't gone away. How many degrees do you have? It's still there. Because that feeling comes because we're the fixation with this one idea, the silly idea of replacing reality, the new reality, which gave rise to what we call existence. We're fixated on that to the exclusion of all other ideas. And as long as we continue this exclusive fixation with this one idea, we will still feel incompetent no matter how many degrees, no matter how many houses we own, how many cars, no matter how many vacations, you name it. It doesn't matter if everybody in the universe worships us as God, we will still feel that sense of incompetence. It doesn't matter how many beautiful clothes we wear, jewelry, right? That feeling of incompetence is still there. We can be in lots of movies and have lots of photographs taken of us. We can create music. We can be very creative. Doesn't matter. Still feel that feeling of incompetence. It won't go away. It won't go away until we remember that we remember who we are, what we are, and exercise our capacity to choose ideas, choose a new idea. Once we do that, we'll say, I'm competent once again, because now I'm flowing spontaneously through ideas and experiencing them. And then that feeling of incompetence will vanish. And even we try to get rid of that feeling of incompetence by studying all sorts of spiritual teachings and going to many spiritual teachers too, right? Many spiritual practices, building our spiritual resume. But that too doesn't get rid of it. See, spirituality is not an end in itself. We're just trying to add another higher degree than a Ph.D. Maybe we'll be a spiritual master or a guru or something like that. That doesn't get rid of the incompetence. Doesn't matter if you have all the world worshipping you as a guru. Doesn't get rid of it. It's still there. But if you recognize this dynamic, you say, okay, it's still there. I know I have to eventually get to the point of choosing a new idea. But right now we're lessening the fixation on this silly idea of existence. We're lessening our fixation, and we know that will eventually result in choosing a new idea, and that will get rid of this feeling of incompetence. So we're not chasing degrees here. We're not chasing status, not so severely. Of course, a little bit of that is going to be there, but it'll lessen up, it'll loosen up, lighten up. Not such a big deal. No, not at all. Okay. Wonderful. That's it. Oh.